Today we are dealing with the chemical bonding and molecular structure. So first we are dealing with the orbit, the difference between orbit and orbital. What are the differences between orbit and orbital? So orbit is the path through which electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Orbit is the path through which electrons are revolving around the nucleus, while orbital, it is the place of probability of finding electron. Orbital is the place of probability of finding electrons. Second, orbit is two-dimensional, but orbital, it is three-dimensional. Two-dimensional is x-axis and y-axis only, but orbital is three-dimensional, x, y, z-axis. The maximum number of electron in orbit is given by 2n square. But maximum number of electron in an orbital is only 2 electrons. So that is the difference between orbit and orbital. We are going to study the orbital overlapping. Orbital overlapping. So different types of orbital overlapping are there. That is, orbitals having similar energy, they undergoes overlapping. For example, S-S overlapping. That is, one S orbital undergoes overlapping with, this is the 1s and 1s orbital. They undergo coaxial overlapping. This overlapping can be takes place in two methods. One is coaxial overlapping, which lead to the formation of sigma bond, and second is lateral overlapping, which lead to the formation of pi bond. So two types of overlapping is possible. One is coaxial overlapping, which lead to the formation of sigma bond, very strong bond, and the second is lateral overlapping, which lead to the formation of pi bond, which is a weak bond. So here when S undergoes overlapping with the 1s, it is called SS overlapping, and this is a coaxial overlapping, so that gives a sigma bond. Now if SP overlapping, one S orbital and one P orbitals undergoes overlapping to give sigma bond, that overlapping is called SP overlapping. That is the case of hydrogen chloride, hydrogen S orbital and chlorine p orbital. So they undergo coaxial overlapping, lead to formation of a sigma bond. So SS overlapping, SP overlapping. Now next is PP overlapping. So one p orbital, that is chlorine. When you consider chlorine molecule Cl2, the p orbital of pz orbital of chlorine overlap with the pz orbital of the chlorine. So this is Cl2, this lead to form a sigma bond. P orbital overlap with the P, so they are coaxial overlapping, which lead to the formation of sigma bond. So two type of bond, one is sigma bond and the second is pi bond. So SS overlapping, S orbital overlapping with another S orbital, coaxial overlapping, sigma bond. S orbital overlap P orbital to give SP overlapping in the case of hydrogen chloride. Then PP overlapping, chlorine molecule, 2P or PZ orbitals undergoes coaxial overlapping to give sigma bond, and that is PP overlapping. So next is pi bond formation. When the atomic orbitals undergoes lateral overlapping, the bond formed is called a pi bond, and that is a weak bond. Then two, like this, one p orbital and this p orbital, they undergo overlapping laterally. So this will lead to the formation of a pi bond. So when two atomic orbitals undergoes lateral overlapping, that will lead to the formation of a pi bond. A pi bond is a weak bond. So this can be seen in the case of ethylene. CH2 double bond CH2, you can see this pi bond. Here these are overlapped by hydrogen atom, and here this P overlap to give the sigma bond, and this gives a pi bond, that is CH2 double bond CH2 ethylene. So these are sigma bonds. This sigma bond, sigma bond, sigma bond, and sigma bond, and that is a pi bond. One p orbitals, they undergo lateral overlapping due to the formation of a pi bond. So that about this sigma bond and a pi bond. Next we are going to study what is hybridization and what are the different types of hybridizations. Hybridization. What is hybridization and what are the different types of hybridization? So when you consider carbon, atom number 6, so this is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. That is the electronic configuration of carbon. So when you explain the formation of methyl CH4, there should be 4 vacant d orbitals. There should be 4 vacant orbitals in carbon atom. There should be 4 unpaired electrons. Carbon should have 4 unpaired electrons, that is, which contain 1 electron each. Then only it can overlap with the 4 hydrogen atoms. So here, in order to explain the formation of methyl, this is in the normal state. We require 4 unpaired orbitals for the formation of methyl. So for that, this is the normal state. And in the excited state, one electron from 2s will be shifted to vacant p orbitals. Here one electron will be shifted to this vacant one. So one electron will be shifted to vacant pz orbital. Now there are 4 unpaired orbitals. So if hydrogen can overlap with this hybridization, so here carbon undergoes sp3 hybridization. Carbon undergoes sp3 hybridization. Why? If hydrogen overlap here with the 4 unpaired orbitals, this bond will be s orbital, so it will be shortened bond. This is p orbital, order different, so the bond will be 4 bonds here. 3 bond will be similar, but 4th bond will be different. But in methyl, all the bonds are equal. So to explain that, we are using the term hybridization. So hybridization is the process of mixing up of 2 or more different orbital of comparable energy to form equivalent orbitals. Hybridization is the process of mixing up of 2 or more different orbitals of comparable energy to form equivalent orbitals having same energy. That process is hybridization. So here carbon undergoes sp3 hybridization. That is, 1 s orbital and 3 p orbital take part in hybridization to give 4 equivalent orbitals. So carbon 6, 1s2, and this gives sp3 hybridized orbital. sp3 hybridized orbital. So here 4 orbitals we are getting, sp3 hybridized orbital. So here the peculiarity is all the 4 orbitals have the same shape, same energy. So After sp3 hybridization, the shape of the orbital is tetrahedral. Tetrahedral, that's the shape. Like this. So that is the tetrahedral shape of carbon atom. After the sp3 hybridization, carbon will have four equivalent orbitals. And here, in the case of methane, these orbitals are overlapped with hydrogen atoms. Here, it is overlapped with hydrogen atoms to give sigma bonds. So that is the methane molecule, CH4. Shape is tetrahedral, bond angle 109.5. 109.5 degree. That is the bond angle. So what is once more? Hybridization is the process of mixing up of two or more orbitals having equivalent some comparable energy to form equivalent orbitals having same energy. That is hybridization. So in the case of sp3 hybridization, one s orbital and three p orbitals take part in hybridization to give this molecule. Another example related with the sp3 hybridization is water, H2O. In water also, oxygen undergoes sp3 hybridization. Because oxygen contains two unpaired orbitals, if hydrogen overlaps with these two unpaired orbitals, the bond angle will be only 90 degree. But in water, the bond angle is not 90 degree. So we have to explain on the basis of hybridization. So next example is water, H2O, oxygen, atom number 8, that is 1s2. 2s2, 2p. And this electronic configuration of oxygen, 1s2, 2s2, 2px2, 2py1 and 2pz1. So here, if hydrogen overlap here, the bond angle will be only 90 degree. But in water, the bond angle is 104.5 degree. Bond angle is 104.5 degree. So we have to explain hybridization. So here in the excited state, so here oxygen undergoes sp3 hybridization. Oxygen 8, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So this undergoes sp3 hybridization. So after sp3 hybridization, you have studied that the shape will be tetrahedral having four orbitals having equivalent energy and shape. So here two orbitals are occupied by two lone pairs and two orbitals are occupied by two hydrogen atoms. These two contain two lone pairs. So in water, two lone pair and two bond pairs. Bond angle 104.5 degree. Hybridization is sp3. Two bond pair and two lone pair. What is a lone pair? If the orbitals contain unshared electrons, that is electrons which are not taking part in bond formation, then that is called a lone pair electron. So these two are the two lone pair electrons and these two are the bond pair and these two bond pairs and two lone pairs shape is tetrahedral. That's a tetrahedral is the geometry, but the shape of the molecule is bent molecule. Shape is bent because the lone pair orbitals will not consider in the shape. So even though it undergoes sp3 hybridization, geometry is tetrahedral, but the shape of the molecule is bent molecule or V shape. Bend or V shape. That is inverted V. Because the lone pair orbitals will not consider in the shape. So that is the formation of water H2O. So next molecule you have to study is NH3, ammonia. In ammonia, nitrogen, atomic number 7. So it contains 3 unpaired orbitals. The 2p contains 3 unpaired orbitals. So if hydrogen overlap directly with this unpaired orbitals, the bond angle will be only 90 degree. But in ammonia, the bond angle is 107. So we have to use again hybridization process. Nitrogen, atomic number 7, 1s2, 2s2, and 2p contain one electron each in the orbital. So if hydrogen directly overlap here, the bond angle will be only 90 degree, but in ammonia, bond angle is 107 degree. Bond angle is 107 degree. So we have to use hybridization process. So here is also nitrogen is undergoing sp3 hybridization. Nitrogen undergoes sp3 hybridization. So nitrogen 1s2, 2s2, 2p each. This is sp3 hybridization. So again here geometry is tetrahedral having 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. So this is a lone pair electron and 3 bond pair electrons. So this is a bond, this is a bonded orbitals and this is a lone pair orbital. So in ammonia, even though it undergoes sp3 hybridization, geometry is tetrahedral, shape of the molecule is triagonal pyramid. So it can be represented like this. Nitrogen, here hydrogen atoms, and this contains a lone pair of electron. So hybridization is sp3, bond angle is 107, shape is trigonal pyramid. So even though in ammonia nitrogen undergoes sp3 hybridization, the bond angle is only 107 degree. So what is the reason? Here we contain a lone pair and 3 bond pairs, so there will be repulsion between lone pair and bond pair. So due to that repulsion, bond angle is reduced to 107 degree. In water, the bond, even though it undergoes sp3 hybridization, the bond angle is only 104.5 degree. Again, here in the case of water, there will be 2 lone pairs. So repulsion between lone pair is greater than repulsion between lone pair and bond pair. So because of the 2 lone pairs in water, bond angle is reduced to 104.5 degree. In ammonia, only one lone pair, so bond angle is reduced to 107 degree. Shape is trigonal pyramid. Hybridization is sp3. So next hybridization we have to study is sp2 hybridization. In sp2 hybridization, one s orbital and 2p orbitals take part in hybridization. In sp2, 1s orbital and 2p orbitals take part in hybridization. So let us look. Second is sp hybridization, sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybridization. So here we take the example of ethylene, CH2 double bond CH2, and BE VF3 and CH2 double bond CH2. These are sp2 hybridized orbitals. So first you look about the VF3 boron atom number 5, that is 1s2, 2s2, and the 2p contain only one electron. But in order to form BF3, we require 3 unpaired orbitals. So for that, one electron from 2s will be shifted. Here one electron will be shifted to 2p, vacant 2p. So excited state. In the excited state, one electron from the 2s will be shifted to the vacant 2p orbital. Now there are 3 unpaired orbitals, and this is 2s and 2p. So here this boron undergoes sp2 hybridization. So boron 5, 1s, 2s, one electron will be shifted here. One s two, 2s1. So after hybridization, we have tried this. This is sp2 hybridized orbital, and here it is one vacant 2p orbital. So boron undergoes sp2 hybridization to give 3 unpaired orbitals, and there is a 1 2p is a vacant orbital. Now after the sp2 hybridization, the shape of the molecule is trigonal planar. Bond angle is 120. Hybridization sp2. So here the fluorine molecule overlap here. So this is BF3, boron trifluoride, BF3. Shape trigonal planar, hybridization sp2, bond angle 120 degree. That is see. So here boron atom number 5, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. In the excited state, one electron will be shifted from 2s to 2p. Now there are 3 unpaired orbitals. So boron undergoes sp2 hybridization. because in the, if it undergoes a spin hybridization, it will give three equivalent orbitals. We require three equivalent orbitals. So here it undergoes a spin hybridization, then it will give trigonal planar structure having a bond angle 120 degree. Now fluorine here overlaps here to give sigma bonds. So this is the structure of the boron trifluoride for sp2 hybridization. Then another example related with this sp2 hybridization is ethylene C2H4, that is ethylene CH2 double bond CH2. So in the case of ethylene, again carbon, we have to consider carbon. Atomic number is 6. Configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Only 2 unpaired electrons. So next molecule is ethylene. CH2 double bond CH2. Ethylene. Or ethene. Carbon, atomic number 6, 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. That is the configuration for carbon. Now in the excited state, one electron will be shifted to here. Excited state. Carbon 6. 1s2, 2s1, and 2p3. Now there are 4 unpaired orbitals, but for the formation of ethylene, ethylene molecule is like this. We require 3 orbitals, 2 orbital for 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 orbital for connecting with the neighboring carbon atom. So we require only 3 orbitals. So here carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization. Carbon undergoes sp2. The reason is why? Because we require only 3 orbitals for bond formations. 2 with hydrogen atoms and 1 with the neighboring carbon atom. So carbon 6, 1s2, 2. This is sp2 hybridized orbital. And here is 1 p orbital. 2p in 1 orbital. So here carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization. So that gives 1 carbon atom and the other carbon atoms. sp2 hybridized carbon atoms. So that gives trigonal shape. Carbon atoms. Here hydrogen overlap, hydrogen overlap, hydrogen overlap, and unhydrogen overlap to give sigma bond. But here it is a 1 unhybridized orbital. There is a 1 unhybridized orbital. So that orbital is perpendicular. Unhybridized orbital which is perpendicular. So this can undergo only lateral overlapping. So they undergo lateral overlapping to give a pi bond. So in ethylene, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 sigma bonds are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sigma bond and 1 pi bond is there. That is about the hybridization ethylene. Carbon atomic number 6. So there are 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. In the excited state, one electron will be shifted to form 4 unpaired orbitals. But the carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization because we require only 3 unpaired orbitals. So that gives three orbitals is undergoes sp2 hybridization and one unhybridized p orbital. So that gives this structure of ethylene. Here 5 sigma bond and 1 pi bond. That is in the case of ethylene, sp2 hybridization. Next is sp hybridization. sp hybridization. So what is sp?